Roll over Beethoven, gotta hit it again today. Roll over Beethoven, roll over Beethoven, roll over Beethoven, roll over Beethoven.
Past 11, Belinda. You cannot have failed to have heard the chimes. If I, whose hearing was damaged by a German artillery barrage...
All right, Daddy, everyone knows you heeded your country's call in 1939.
Why? What happened in 1939?
I think you better go now, Julie.
The post-war generation. Did you see that? Lipstick, high heels, dyed hair... And how old could she be? 12? 13? I would never have let you dress like that when you were her, eh?
You still don't let me, Daddy.
Someone has to maintain standards. Come along, Arnold. I just thank the good Lord I retired from teaching when I did.
Oh, for heaven's sake, don't start that again.
I can pinpoint the exact moment the country began to go to the dogs.
It was the autumn term, 1963.
The autumn term, 1963. I noticed it at the very first assembly. We were singing All Things Bright and Beautiful. And half my boys were adding, yeah, 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 at the end of every verse. Oh, Arnold, what have you been up to? The entire sixth form were affecting Liverpool accents, sprouting hair down to their coat collars, wearing Chelsea boots, all the fault of those damn Beetle. They set us upon the slippery slope that led to Harold Wilson, the common market decimalisation.
I always thought the Beatles were rather sweet.
I wrote to the Times, you know.
You always do, Daddy. Where is it all leading, you demanded?
They didn't print it. They never do.
It's led, I tell you, it's led to this damn pop singer buying the ground of one of the finest houses in the entire county. Why couldn't the National Trust buy the place?
Probably your damn pop singer had more money than the National Trust.
Leave the poor chap alone.
Oh, no, sorry, we don't want any heather.
I'm not selling any. You Mrs. Purcell?
Yes, only it's Miss, actually.
Oh, really?
Is it about the drains?
Drains? No, no. Says here you teach music.
Yes, piano's my forte.
Oh, funny as well as tasty. Oh, devastating.
Is it about piano lessons?
Got it in one, doll.
Oh, well, I suppose you'd better come through.
Yeah. Cheers. Oh, I've got a Steinway.
Yes. You're familiar with the piano?
Familiar? I was Barry Manilow's roadie for 3 years, wasn't I? Ta-da! Oh, I don't want that mooted about, though. I was very short of cash at the time.
Belinda, it's early closing, and I'm down to last iron jelloid.
My father.
Oh, you don't live alone, then?
No. Excuse me. Tell me, Mr.
Lem.
Len? Mm. Yes, for whom do you wish to book piano lessons?
Well, it's my, my boss. I mean, you do grown-ups, don't you?
Well, not usually, but there's no rule against it.
So, what are your rates?
350 a year, which is outrageous, when you consider they only empty the dustbins when the mood takes them. Has he come about the drain?
Daddy, I thought you were deaf today.
Where's my coffee?
Sorry about that. Actually, I charge £5 an hour, but if that's too much...
That's no sweat, no. He's got more money than the Duke of Westminster.
Who has?
Look. No. Can you keep a secret?
Honor Bright.
Nigel Cochran.
Nigel? Who?
Nigel Cochran. You know, Graf Spain? Rock and roll? We're living up the Grange.
Oh, it's you.
Right. So now you understand why our arrangements must be kept under wraps.
Not really, no.
Look, Nigel splits the world's number one rock band to make a solo album, right? Big news in Rock City. Now, we would be extremely pissed off if the news leaked out he's got to take piano lessons first, right? That's why we've selected an obscure little music teacher like your good self.
Oh, I'm thrilled a bit.
And so you should be. Right, motor will be here at 2 o'clock. Fetch you up the Grange.
Just a moment, Mr.
Len, what's the matter? 2 o'clock, no good.
No, it's not that. It's just that my pupils visit me here.
Yeah, Nigel doesn't go out. He don't want no one seeing him.
Well, that's as maybe, but my father's not as young as he used to be, and he was pretty old then.
Oh, drat me. All right. You promise you will not bang it to the press?
Sorry?
Talk to the newspapers.
Oh, well, under the circumstances, I won't even tell Daddy.
Oh. You sure she wasn't winding you up?
Yeah.
Oh, Lem. You lost me my free game now.
Right. Dinner? You served.
Dinner is cold.
It's not my fault, man. Pop down the nearest McDonald's, you said. Hey, do you know where it is? Dorking. Bloody miles
away.
Oh,
Lem! Fuse the machine. Stick it all in the microwave. And not the champagne, Lem. That's warm enough already.
Hold up. May I remind you, you are dealing with a man who's used to room service. When we was on the road, right, we had everything on tap. Booze, food, raving delinquent young girls.
Yeah, well, those days of wanton, mindless excess are over, Lem. So what time's this piano teacher coming round, then?
I forgot to tell you, she can't come up here. You've got to go down to her pad.
Lem, I'm trying to keep a low profile, remember?
Nigel, she's cool.
Oh, what? That is all I need. The rest of the band here and I'm taking music lessons. Oh, no.
That's Commoner Garden Indian tea. Where's my Earl Grey?
Mr. Daventry no longer stocks it, Daddy. He says it just isn't worth it for one customer.
Not worth it? Change and decay and all around I see. Just a moment, Belinda. Are you wearing rouge and pancake?
I have applied the merest touch of makeup.
Touch? That stuff is half an inch thick all over your face.
Well, I just want to make a reasonable impression. My new pupil happens to be an adult.
You mean a man?
A male adult, yes.
I forbid you to teach him.
Oh, don't be so ridiculous, Daddy. He's paid for 20 lessons in advance. £100.
£100? In my day, only one sort of man gave a woman that sort of money. And only one sort of woman accepted it. The sort of woman that wore makeup. Your mother never wore makeup.
You never let her, Daddy.
Coast clear?
Pretty much so, but they forecast sea mist over Rock Hall, Fair Isle and German Bight.
I'm talking about the press, and I? Lurking at, you know.
This is Churston Deckel, not Gatcombe Park.
Right. Gatcombe Park? What's she talking about? Right, go. Two down. Now, do you recognise him?
No.
Who do you reckon he is? Ronnie Biggs with an air transplant?
No, Lem, it's cool. So, you really don't know who I am?
Well, perhaps if I could see your eyes.
Glosses.
Perhaps not.
Oh, Lem!
Not a budgie.
Well, he only wears them when he wants to appear inconspicuous.
Inconspicuous? In leather trousers and cowboy boots in this village?
Well, you got a point there. Why didn't you think of that, Lem?
I was the one who talked him out of a Lurex jacket.
Yes, now, shall we get on with the first lesson?
Where's the old Joanna, then? Through there?
Yes. It's best that my father doesn't find out who you are. He doesn't really approve.
No, they never do.
Good God, a socialist.
Oh, blimey, it's a Dalek.
It's that damned caterwauling pop singer I signed a petition against.
Please, Daddy, he's only come for a piano lesson.
Here we go.
Out of my house.
Oh, God. Lem. Right, that's it. Bad vibes. Lem. Lem.
Oi. We're going to do without all the aggro, you know.
Out.
Pop. We've got enough trouble with the inland revenue.
Out.
Off we go. Come on. That's it. Come on. Out. All right, lad. Now, remember, next time, the next lesson is up at a gro. Right, like we said. Come on. Home.
Sir, it is lamentable enough when one of the finest country houses in England falls into the grasp of a pop singer. How much more offensive is it to discover that Nigel Cochrane, the leather-clad crooner in question, is so incompetent a musician that he has to seek musical tuition before he can embark on his next magnum opus? And to think the man is a millionaire. I am, sir, your obedient servant.
To the editor, Times, print... No. Send it to the local paper, get it published.
How the other half lives?
Yeah. Here we have our Van Gogh.
Is that an original?
Yeah, of course. No investment potential in reproduction, so Nigel says.
It's beautiful.
Yeah, nice, isn't it, eh? We won that playing darts with Stevie Wonder.
But isn't he, Well, I hope you gave him a start.
We told him we did.
Here,
come here. These are the fruits of victory.
Gosh, Nigel's pop group must have sold an awful lot of long players.
Yeah, we've done all right.
Were you actually in the group, Lem? You always say we. I mean, do you play an instrument?
Not as such, no. I'm Nigel's equipment manager and joint roller. Mind you, I was featured heavily on one album track.
Oh, doing what?
Hand clapping. Clean in my coffee, clean in my tea. Bah, bah, bah.
Oh, she's jolly pretty. Who's she?
Yeah, that's Crazy Laura.
Oh, Friend of Nigel's?
No way, no. She was a model on an album cover. Started on the sleeve, ended up in his trousers. Whee!
Oh, hi there. Sorry to keep you hanging around, only I've been talking to California.
Oh, all of it?
What a god!
See you later, Len.
Yeah, have a nice time, Nigel. That's all right. I got for a spin in the jacuzzi.
Yeah, well, don't eat crisps in it this time. It blocks the filter.
Is the jacuzzi another one of your cars?
Nice one!
Not exactly, no. Well, shall we get straight on down and do that funky thing, then?
Don't you think we ought to stick to music?
Yeah, that's what I meant. I mean, what do you think I meant?
Oh, nothing. It's just, you know, the thing. Things one reads about you pop people, yeah.
What's he been saying about me? Isn't all that stuff about Bangkok and the baby clams, that is total lies, right? Anyway, I'm a grown-up now, right? I'm a ratepayer. What I want to do now, right, is get myself accepted as a serious musician and like, creator of concept albums. Come on, over here. We have got a piano, only they're taking ages spraying it to match the carpet, so we'll have to make do with this.
Oh, that's all right. What is it?
It's a synthesizer. Have you ever seen one before?
No.
Sorry, wrong setting. It's quite fun, isn't it?
I thought you said you couldn't play.
No, I can't. I used to be a red hot bass player, mind you. I invented the two heaviest riffs of the decade. Yeah, apart from that, I mean, on this, I just know enough chords to work out my songs.
Is that one of your tunes?
Yep.
Well, why have you stopped?
Well, it's crap, isn't it?
Well, I can't possibly tell until I've heard it. Why don't you play it for me?
What, now?
Yes.
Oh, all right.
What did I see in you that brought me through from spring to summer? And as our time unfolds, our simple souls have grown together magically. Yeah. Why should that be? What did I see in you? What did I feel in you? What did I find that brought me to my childhood's end? To start my life again. To start my life again.
Well, that's sort of it. What do you reckon?
It's lovely. Though I changed that natural to a diminished.
Yeah. Yeah, that's quite a classy chord, that is. The rest of the band will get off on that. That's an upmarket chord, that is.
You seem very concerned about what the rest of your band will think. I thought you'd left them.
Oh, yeah, I have, but it doesn't mean I don't want to impress them. I want this first album that I'm going to do to come like a huge surprise, right? You see, they all think I'm a prize wally. They don't think I can do it.
Of course you can do it, Nigel.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, now, shall we get on with the lesson? Let's start with the scale of C major.
Is that the one without the black notes?
Yes.
Wait. Cop an earful of this.
Since Grass Bay split, that's a mouthful, and Nigel Cochran came back to England. So what has this reclusive superstar been up to?
I'm not reclusive, so just don't go out much.
Solo album, but first we hear Nigel is having to take, wait for it, music lessons? Talk about Roll Over Beethoven, but let's remember Nigel with Grass Bay doing what he does best, playing bass.
You cow.
And to think the man is a millionaire.
I've never been spoken to in such a way in my whole life.
Something wrong, though?
That dreadful pop singer accused me of telling some commercial radio station.
What on earth is a commercial radio station?
He said that I did it for the publicity, that I wanted people to know that I was actually teaching him.
I hate to say this, my dear, but I said he'd turn out to be a thoroughly bad egg.
Don't you find it wearying, always being right?
Did once, but now I'm used to it.
Must be a village. It was a rotten thing to do.
Rotten? I call it a public-spirited act.
You telephoned that radio station, didn't you?
Me? Nonsense. As if I'd have anything to do with a commercial, one of those institutions responsible for the decline of this great country.
Then what should I make of this?
Mice?
With scissors?
Oh, very well. I've got nothing to hide. I wrote to the local newspaper. I did it for the good of the whole community.
I hope you realise you may have blighted Nigel's entire career.
Oh, do you really think so? And what about my cup?
I'll be making a statement through my record company.
Please don't hang up. This is Belinda.
Oh, goodbye.
No, listen, please. I'm sorry, but Daddy thought he was acting for the best.
Well, what's Daddy got to do with it?
Well, I'm afraid he wrote to the local paper about you.
Oh, did he? Well, he's an evil old bastard, tell him.
There's no need to adopt that tone of voice. I'm very sorry if you've been inconvenienced. I just thought that apologies were in order. Good evening.
Yeah, all right. I'm sorry I... That was Thingy. Belinda.
Miss Supergrass, 1983.
It's a shame about her, really. I was just beginning to fancy her and all.
Oh. So the stuff crazy Laura put in your tea's starting to wear off, is it?
Don't you think she could look sort of tasty?
No.
Yeah, sort of normal.
You honestly reckon you can pull a bird like that after the way you slagged her off this afternoon? No chance, mate.
I bet I can.
You're on.
Now, look here, Arnold. You just pull yourself together and let's have no more of this mildew nonsense. I'll be the judge of that, sir. Don't mind. Oh, hello, Bill. I was just giving Arnold a good old talking to.
Your coffee, Daddy.
Oh, I
Dark roast, medium ground, Costa Rican, one spoonful of Demerara sugar and a dash of cream.
Spot on.
No, it's instant.
Well, you know I can't abide instant coffee.
Of course I know, Daddy.
She's still cross with us, aren't you?
Seething, Daddy.
Now, look here, my girl. I brought you up to be a good loser, so you just snap out of it. Why don't you go and play something for us? Like you used to when you were a little girl.
That's how you'd like to keep me, isn't it? A little girl. That's why whenever a man enters my life in any way, you carry out your acts of petty sabotage. That's why you were so beastly to Nigel, because you were frightened that I found him... that I might find him attractive.
Attractive? That yobbo. He could never be good enough for you.
Oh, Prince Andrew wouldn't be good enough for me.
Certainly not, the sort of company he keeps.
God, Daddy, you're beyond belief.
Contented together, you and I. What is that, Brahms? Debussy?
Neither. It's Nigel Cochran. You know, that damn yobbo.
I'll make my own blasted coffee. I wasn't going to say anything, but I've been in dreadful pain all day. Shrapnel must be on the move. I wouldn't be surprised if it didn't rain later.
Hello?
Yeah?
You were playing my song?
No, I'm not.
Oh, well, it sounded like it.
Yes, well, your song sounds like a lot of songs. It's very derivative.
Oh, it's the life I've led, see?
What are you doing here, anyway?
Oh, come to apologise, so I brought you some flowers.
Well, with your money, that's a very easy way of saying sorry.
Yeah, but I brought them myself, didn't I? I didn't ring into Flora or nothing. I walked.
Well, all the way from the Grange?
No, from the limo.
How many are there?
99.
Why not 100?
I don't want to be that flash.
Well, I don't want to be that easy. I'll take 2 dozen.